mirth, spring, to linger in a garden fair. What more has earth to give? All ye that wait, where is the cupbearer? The flagon where? When pleasant hours slip from the hand of fate, reckon each hour as a certain gain. Who seeks to know the end of mortal care shall question his experience in vain. Thy fettered life hangs on a single thread. Some comfort for thy present ills devise, but those that time may bring thou shalt not dread. Waters of life in Irem's paradise. What meaning do our dreams and pomp convey, save that beside a mighty stream, wide fed, we sit and sing of wine and go our way? The modest and the merry shall be seen to boast their kinship with a single voice. There are no differences to choose between. Thou art but flattering thy soul with choice. Who knows the curtain's secret? Heaven is mute. And yet with him who holds the curtain, e'en with him, O braggart, thou wouldst raise dispute. Although his thrall shall miss the road of error, 'tis but to teach it wisdom through distress. Else pardon and compassionate mercy were but empty syllables and meaningless. The zealot thirsts for violence of Kowser's wine. The fools doth an earthly cup prefer, but what between the two is God's design? End of poem 11. Poem 12. Where is my ruined life, and where the fame of noble deeds? Look on my long-drawn road, and whence it came, where it leads. Can drunkenness be linked to piety and good repute? Where is the picturesque holy melody? Where is the lute? The monkey's cell and lined garb released, O heart of mine. Where is the tavern fame, the tavern priest? Where is the wine? Past days of meeting, let the memory of you be sweet. Where are those glances fled? And where for me reproaches meet? His friend's bright face warms not the enemy. When love is done, where is the extinguished lamp that made night day? Where is the sun? Balm to my eyes, the dust, my head I bow upon thy stare. Where shall I go? Where from thy presence? Thou art everywhere. Look not upon the dimple of her chin, danger lurks there. Where wilt thou hide, O trembling heart, fleeing in such mad haste? Where? To steadfastness and patience, friend, ask not if Hafiz keep. Patience and steadfastness I have forgot, and where is sleep? End of poem 12. Poem 13. Lady that hast my heart within thy hand, thou heed'st me not, and if thou turn thine ear unto the wise, thou shalt not understand. Behold, the fault is thine, our words were clear. For all the tumult in my drunken brain, praise God, who trieth not his slave in vain. Nor this world nor the next shall make me fear. My weary heart eternal silence keeps. I know not what has slipped into my heart, but I am silent, one within me weeps. My soul shall rend the painted veil apart. Where art thou, minstrel? Touch thy saddest strings to clothe the music such as sorrow sings. My mournful story from thy zither sweeps. Lo, not at any time I lent mine ear to hearken to the glories of the earth. Only thy beauty to mine eyes was dear. Sleep has forsaken me, and from the birth of night till day I weave bright dreams of thee. Drunk with a hundred nights of revelry, where is the tavern that sets forth such cheer? My heart, sad hermit, stains the cloister floor with drops of blood, the sweat of anguish dire. Ah, wash me clean, and o'er my body pour love's generous wine. The worshippers of fire have bowed them down and magnified thy name, for in my heart there burns a living flame, transpiercing death's impenetrable door.
Thank you. I Thank you. Thank you.
To a cruel Ethiopian band. Sorrow despoiled the kingdom of my heart. Return, glad Lord of Rome, and free the land. Before thine arms the foe shall break and part. See now, I hold a mirror to mine eyes, and naught but thy reflection therein lies. The glass speaks truth to them that understand. Night is with child, hast thou not heard men say? Night is with child, what will she bring to birth? I sit and ask the stars when thou art away. Oh, come, and when the nightingale of mirth pipes in the spring awakened garden ground, in Hafiz's heart shall ring a sweeter sound. Diviner nightingales attune their lay. End of poem 15. Poem 16. What is wrought in the forge of the living and life? All things are naught. Ho, fill me the bowl, for naught is the gear of the world and the strife. One passion has quickened the heart and the soul. The beloved's presence alone they have sought. Love at least exists, but if love were not, heart and soul would sink to the common lot. All things are naught. Like an empty cup is the fate of each, and each must fill from life's mighty flood. Naught thy toil, though to paradise gate thou reach, if another has filled up thy cup with blood. Neither shame from the sweet fruited trees to be bought, of the praying of cypress of truth, dost not see that Sidra and Tuba were naught, and to thee all then were naught. The span of thy life is as 5 little days, brief hours, and swift to this halting place. Rest softly, ah, rest, while the shadow delays, for time self is naught in the dial space. On the lip of oblivion we linger, and short is the way from the lip to the mouth where we pass. While the moment is thine, fill, O Saki, the glass, ere all is naught. Consider the rose that breaks into flower, neither repines, though she fade and die. The powers of the world endure for an hour, but naught shall remain of their majesty. Be not too sure of your crown, you who thought that virtue is easy, and recompense yours. From the monastery to the wine tavern doors, the way is naught. What, though I too have tasted the salt of my tears, though I too have burnt in the fires of grief, shall I cry alone to unheeding ears? Mourn and be silent, naught brings relief. Thou, Hafiz, art praised for the songs thou hast wrought, but bearing a stained or an honored name, the lovers of wine shall make light of thy fame. All things are naught. End of poem 16. Poem 17. Lay not